See, a person, whenever you are confident, a person does what? You would be bothered about your face. First thing, you'd be bothered about your face. Second would be your hair. And the third would be your clothing and your hair. So, as a matter of choice, in case you want to judge, like normally when you're judging a person through any sort of means, you judge first by his look. And the, when you're talking about the look, the first thing that matters about, apart from your facial expressions or your posture, would be the state of the hair, that is your hair. So if you have good hair, that also represents, like, you know, a good self-esteem. It could be related to something, okay, on your, maybe you don't realize in the very first time, but that has got a very, your physiological health, that means the state of your health, has got a lot of consideration with the quality of the state of your hair. That means if your hair shows promising volume and vitality, that means all your system means your digestions, your elimination and your physiological full body is living or is working in harmony with each other, right? The first thing that we need to consider, in my earlier session has concentrated, in my earlier session have concentrated on three parts whenever I have been tackling hair loss. The first factor that I have been concentrating on was the, now the hygiene, we are talking generally, when you talk about the hygiene of the whole body, but in this particular issue, we won't be talking about the whole body, we will be specifically concentrating on a discussion related to scalp, right? Because the first and the foremost condition that if you want to erase your hair losses, what you need to do, and you need to see to that your scalp is totally clean. And for keeping it clean, I have advocated and I have told you the methods, like you can use herbal oils, you can use warm, simple olive oil, or you can use a hot towel treatment, that before a bath. It could be used maybe twice in a week or thrice in a week, depending on the condition. So when you do that, your dead cells, which keeps on accumulating on your scalp, and they are the ones, because the accumulation keeps on occurring again and again, and that leads to, you can say, that leads to the blockage of the circulation in your scalp. And as a reason, what happens, the hair root do not get sufficient nutrition. Because each root, each square edge on your skin, on your scalp, is associated with at least 38 square. And these square glands are responsible for providing the nutrition for your hair. Nutrition means obviously your herbal oils or whatever you apply on your scalp. So this part is being blocked when you are not taking care of your scalp in a right manner. Now maybe everybody say, okay, I take bath every day, I'm taking bath, I'm using it, every day I'm using a imported shampoo. See, taking bath daily does not mean that you are really taking care of your hair. But when you're taking bath, if you're leaving your shampoo, nowadays all the shampoos have got a number of preservative and harsh chemicals. And if you leave it in your hair for about 10 minutes, you're preparing, you're exposing your hair to unnecessary chemicals, or maybe if you're using your hair coloring treatment like dyes or the hair colors, these are unnecessary exposure to chemicals, which also damage the quality and the quantity of hair growth on the long run also, as well as on the short run. We always advise shampoo, but make sure that you don't use or you don't leave your shampoo over a long time when you're taking your washing, right? Because that hampers your scalp. Second part that we have been talking about is the main factor. Now, why this is the main factor? Because again, you got to understand that whenever you're blocking your scalp, whenever the blood is not in a position to reach to your scalp, your all the whatever amount of energy or whatever treatment you're doing, it's like you have closed a door and you're trying to pull it out. It's just going to go unnoticed. So if your circulation is improvised, your circulation is discriminated, your cells would be stimulated, your roots would be in a position to penetrate that particular treatment to your hair tips. And from the hair tips, it would be visible onto your overall hair head. So that is something which we need to consider it in detail. Now last one, I've shown a couple of yogic asanas and breathings. I've shown you what way you can balance the heat elements also in your body, and specifically a few simple and very, very effective asanas which are really effective and proven to solve and to stimulate your circulation or your circulation towards your head, and in turn making sure that your hair loss is being arrested. And then on the long run, it would be in a position to hamper it and to in a position to help you to grow your hair further. Now, third factor that, see, if you're talking about hair, if you're talking about you, if you're talking about beauty, you just got to understand one simple formula or one simple principle, which is the basis of all the oriental sciences or all the treatments which has existed from time from a long time. That is what? Everything what you want to do which is related to hair, beauty and health, they are all connected. They are not two different issues. They are all same thing. It lies the secret of beauty, the secret of hair lies in the harmonious secretion of vital fluids. Okay, now what is vital fluids? Vital fluids is what, when you eat food, that food is getting digested and it is stored in the body in the form of blood. And this blood, when it is circulated in your whole body, it releases the energy which is known as the prana. And this prana or the vital energy is responsible for carrying out all the different activity that we do in our life. Right from our locomotion, your mental work, or whatever we do, we are doing all this activity because of this prana. So when you're choosing the right nutrition, it becomes easier to get the blood which is free from the toxin. And this toxin, since it's not being accumulating in your body, you are in a position to flow it and eliminate it very easily. So your body system is very light. Okay? So slow and simple absorption of your food leads to easy elimination of your waste. And when you follow this principle, that is, in short, in one word, if I would have to describe it, in one sentence, if I would have to describe it, eat simple food, that would never give you the problem in your, like, you know, on your digestion. That will never give you a problem related to your digestion. And your eliminatory processes would be very, very smooth. And this eliminatory processes of smooth means you are sure to get results in your mental attitude, your stress, your depression, and each and every problem that you are coming across will be solved more than half itself. So how would we tackle this particular factor in case of your hair loss? That is what we are going to see in detail today. Keep the toxins away from your body, or how to throw it completely out of your system so that your systems are alive. You don't come across any sort of acidity, gas, constipation and all. And as a result, you can be sure that your system is light enough and you can provide the right nutrition and rest your hair loss. Now we'll start the real workout, what way you need to do it to eliminate this, I mean to stimulate your digestive system. Please remove your shoes and you have to start the workout. Close your eyes, relax yourself. Keep your hands in Gyan Mudra. Let's bring fingers straight. Close your eyes, spine straight. Both your feet flat on the ground, shoulders relaxed, eyes closed, keep your face relaxed, consciously relax your shoulders, legs straight up, close your eyes, inhale deeply, exhale.